Okay, Houston, we've had a problem here.
This is Houston. Say again, please.
Houston, we've had a problem.
So in this second introductory video, I want to talk about this. How do you get to be successful at mastery learning? So what do you need to do to really prepare yourself to learn? Well, instead of me telling you what to do and how to be successful, let's hear from some of last year's students.
You're gonna have a lot of fun in this class, but some advice that I could give you as a person who has graduated high school and has finished GMO class, do all your stuff ahead of time, because if you don't do it ahead of time, even though it is easy, it can pile up and be very stressful. So yeah, just stay on top of your work and you got it.
I guess the advice I would give to the incoming GMO students is just do your videos whenever you can. You know, just get your work done. It's easy, it's fun, you know, and doing your GMO videos whenever you can, or your packet, since it's not too long, you know, you can keep a 100 in that class, you know. And
don't be lazy, don't procrastinate, don't fall behind, because that is the hardest thing to do once you can do something at your own pace, is to fall behind, and then eventually it just stacks over and over and over until you just fall deep in the trench and it's really hard to get out. So just be responsible, do everything on time, and you'll do great in Mr. Bergmann's class.
Make sure you write down what you gotta do so you don't lose track of it. And also, don't wait last minute to do it. The day it's assigned, get all of it done, or as most as you can done. Therefore, you don't get backed up and lose easy points.
Get your work done on time. That's the best advice I can give you. If you do that, you're gonna pass the class and master the course.
Use your class time wisely so that you're not spending all of your time at home doing these labs, because it's going to be so much harder. Just focus in class and you'll be able to get your stuff done.
The one piece of advice that I have for y'all is just to have fun in the class. The class is not stressful. If you get all of your work done on time, and I had a lot of fun with all my classmates. Mr. Bergmann gave us the opportunity to do videos together with our classmates, missions, all kinds of stuff. He's a great teacher. He sets everybody equally to each other. And it doesn't matter who you are or what kind of grades you have, he pushes everybody to do well.
Get your videos done outside of class. And then when you're in class, like, it's literally 10 minutes to do your videos. So then when you're in class, you can definitely get everything done.
All you gotta do is do the work in his class and listen to Mr. B, and you get over 95, guaranteed.
So hopefully that helped you get some ideas of what the student perspectives are. And I want to sort of add to some of the things that they said. And I just want to use a couple of words here. It's going to require you to take some more ownership. You're going to have to, like, take more initiative and say, because here's the deal, right? I'm going to give you a week. Every week, I'm going to say, by the end of the week, you need to get to point X. You need to do this quest and this boss battle, or this whatever, these kinds of ideas. You're going to have a week to get all this stuff done, right? And you need to figure out how you're going to do that. That means that you need to be, you know, more intentional about your learning. And you know, regardless of what our schedule will be, could vary this year a lot, I'm sure, you need to figure out, when am I going to do this? When am I going to do that? One thing that's super important, and you kind of heard this from the students, is if you are doing the pre-work, you must do the pre-work before the time we have it in class. This is such an important thing that you do the pre-work. You must do the pre-work, as they all said. So I'm going to give you a benchmark. So let me go back to this. I'm going to give you a benchmark, and by the end of a particular week, you need to have gotten through, like, assignment X, whatever that might be, and then you're going to get a grade for that. And speaking of grading, right, so everyone wants to know, how do I get graded? Ultimately, it's just this, 50%, 50%. 50% based on how far you get each week, right? You have to get to such and such each week. And 50% on your, and I'm going to call them the boss battles. You might think the word tests. The boss battles plus projects. Now, sometimes the project will take the place of the boss battle. Sometimes it's in addition to. So it's just a simple 50-50 thing. Ultimately, guys, you're going to have some freedom. And I want to encourage you to use your freedom well to learn. Because what's going to really make you better in life, right, and to make you the leader that we want you to be here at Houston Christian, is that you take charge of your own life. All right, ultimately, you need to submit, right, to the King of Kings. But as you learn how to sort of self-regulate and self-lead yourself, it's going to make you so much of a better person long term, and to use that freedom to become the leader I know you can be. Houston, we don't have a problem. And again, I'm so excited to have you in class.